Hello family, this is Gamers Forum back with another interesting video on Clash of Kings. So guys, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe it on big this channel fully focused on tips and tricks regarding Clash of Kings. You will get all the necessary data and details over each and every event over this channel. So guys, before starting the video, I want to announce something that if you have any of the queries, you can contact me on my personal Instagram in the description, as well as you can comment in the comment section of this particular video so that I can sort it out with my best efforts, guys. And don't hesitate to ask anything because this channel belongs to you guys only, guys. So let's begin the video topic. So guys, in today's video we are going to cover out or build out a perfect or at least approximately the perfect of the formation for the max of the p6 castle out here. So I'm going to try out to make a perfect formation for the offensive purpose, and apart from this, guys, I'm using a basic mass size of 400k. Basically my particular basic mass size is around 420k, but I'm using a 400k of the mass size of basic one for this particular build of the formation. So let's begin the video. If we talk about the intro of this particular castle is in kingdom 1554, and this is infantry and cavalry stats based castle. So I'm going to build a perfect formation, but I will help those also who use infantry and archers. I will tell you the trick at the end of the video so that you can convert this particular formation into infantry and archers. So keep that in mind, guys. So let's begin the video, guys. So offensive march, we are going to create the main hero, the main dragon, and the offensive array. Now let's start with the infantry, guys. Infantry, we are going to use every level of the soldiers out here, guys. So let's start with the infantry. Infantry starts with the T13. Okay, 5000 of the T13 infantry. Now 5000 of the razor of the T13 infantry, 5000 of the armor of the T13. Okay guys, apart from this, let's move to the T12 of the infantry. T12, we are going to use 40000 of the T12 of the infantry out here, with 5000 of each razor and tough armor, 5000 and 5000. Okay guys, now let's move to the next section, the T11 of the infantry. Whenever we come to the T11, I am going to use around 50000 of the T11 of the infantry out here, with 10000 of each the razor, 10000 and 10000 of the armor, guys. Okay guys, this is all about the of the infantry unit. Now let's move to the next section, the cavalry, guys. As you can know that I'm a cavalry base, so I'm using T14 of the cavalry in my formation. So I will use 5000 of that particular one out here. If we talk about the Griffin Knights, I'm using 40000 of that one also, 40000 or T13 of the cavalry. Now same with the razor and tough armor, I'm using 5000 each. Now let's move to the T12, guys. T12 of the cavalry, I'm using again 40000, and here in the razor and tough armor, I'm using 10000 of each, because cavalry is the main focus troop that is the best killer in my formation. Okay guys, and apart from this, if we come to the T11 out here, in the T11, I'm using 50000 of the slaughter and 10000 of each razor and tough armor, 10000 and 10000 out here, guys. Apart from this, this is all about the perkler one, guys. And now let's move to the next troop, the archers one. When we come to the archer, let's move towards T13 of the archers out here. Here the Delphire, I'm using 1000 of the Delphire out here. Okay guys, and 500 of each attack and defense of the Delphire, razor and armor, 500 and 500, because I am infantry and cavalry based, so that's why I'm using less of the archers in my formation. And now let's move to the T12. We know that T12 archers is very much helpful in the battlefield, so that's why I'm using 30000 of each, 30000, and attack and defense is 5000 on each side. Archers should be there for we know that people use siege in the formation, so archer is very much helpful for that particular one, guys. I'm not using T11 of the archers in my formation, guys. Okay guys, now let's move to the next one, the siege. For the seed, there are two different types of the T13. One is the elephant and one is the grown seed. There are two types of T13. So for the elephant, I'm using 10,000 of the elephants in my formation. Okay, guys. War elephant 10,000. And now in the grown seed, I'm using out 2,000, approximately 2,000 of the T13 of the grown seed out here. If we talk about the attack and defense, I'm using 1,000 of each. Razor 1,000 and 1,000 off of the armor out here. Okay, guys. And apart from that, I'm using some of the T12 also. Same quantity of the T12 of the siege out here. 2,000 of the basic one. And 1,000 of each attack and armor. 2,000 of the basic one. And okay, I don't have the particular armor of the one, guys, so I'm using only the razor. Okay, guys, 1,000 of the razor I'm using on, and I'm using some of the T11 also, because we know that T11 of the siege is very good killer out here in the battlefield, guys, for the offensive purpose. So I'm using 5,000 of the T11. Okay, guys, apart from that, I'm using some of the razor and armor also, 1,000 of each, 1,000 and 1,000, guys. Okay, guys, apart from this, now whatever is being left, guys, I'm going to use out each and every of the left troops, 100 of each and every of the left troops, guys, whether it is of any level, from level 1 to level 13, whatever troops I have left on, whether it is archers, siege or anything, I'm using 100 of each kind, guys. Okay, guys, keep that in mind. What had happened to my old man? Oh, I just missed out it. 50,000. Okay, guys. So you see out here, I'm using T11, 100 of the one, guys. And now let's move to the one. 100. 100. I'm going to use each and every troops. 100 of each kind. This is known as the troop layering, guys. We know that the offensive purpose, this troop layering is very much important in today's time of the battlefield. So this one helps me a lot. It will help me to gain some time for my troops to engage in the battle, and very much helpful. We know that particular thing. So this one will help out. So I'm going to use up to T7 of the troops only, guys. Okay, guys. I'm not going to use T6, 5, 4. I'm using the layering up to T7 of the troops. Okay, guys, you can see out here I have done everything that is being necessary on. And now, guys, you know, sir, that the particular formation is left on. I have around 13k troops left on. So whatever expansion, we know that the particular one, the enhancement, whatever troops you have enhanced the max, guys, you should use that one. For my particular formation, I'm going to use out the Griffin Knight for the additional purpose. So I'm going to increase it by 53,000 out here. Okay, guys, and 300 is left, so 52,700. Oh, so here is my formation of the 400k of the formation out here. Okay, guys, so I will save it on, guys. So this is the formation that I made on, guys. So this is the formation based on the infantry and the cavalry based stats, guys. So if you are using infantry and archers based stats, what you will do? Whatever quantity of the particular thing that I am using in on the archers, you should go it, you should change it on the cavalry, and you should interchange the amount of the cavalry units on the archers. As you can see out here, I'm using 1,000 of the archers of the Delphi. You can use this particular count on the cavalry unit. Okay, guys, and you should use that particular Griffin count on the particular one. So you should interchange the position of the troops, guys. Whatever amount I'm using out in the particular cavalry section, you have to use on the archer section, and whatever I'm using on the archer section, you should use that particular thing on the cavalry section. You should have to interchange that particular section whenever you are using out infantry and archer. So in today's video, we have covered both of the particular formation for the infantry and cavalry unit for the infantry and archers. So I think that I have done my best to serve out at today's one. This one is also a request from the subscriber, that please make a video on how to make a perfect formation on the offensive. So that's why I made this formation for you guys. I hope that this particular formation will help you in the battle and you will perform well with this particular formation. So that's all about today's video, guys. I hope that you guys like the video information. If you find the video information useful, please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for sure. I will be back with another video as soon as possible. Till then, keep going with Gamers Forum. Thank you, guys.